A very good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us on this very special Facebook Live today, featuring this book, Equally. It's actually spelled Equa Ally, Ally, because we are talking about allies. We have our guest today, Kanak and her son, Anvesh Sahu. Welcome, Kanak, and welcome, Anvesh, to the Facebook Live.
Thanks, Upasana. Very pleased to be here. Thank you for having us.
Our pleasure entirely. So, like I mentioned, Equally is stories by friends of the queer world. It's a first of its kind anthology of powerful personal stories by individuals who have stood up and spoken up for the LGBT plus community and created safe spaces at home, schools, colleges, workplaces, and in society. We'll be happy to take your questions. So please do put them in the comments section. One of the authors right here is Kanak. So Kanak has joined us today. And Kanak is a homemaker, the backbone of the Sahu household, and a devoted wife, mother, and daughter. Welcome, Kanak ji.
Namaste.
Namaste. Kanak ji, mujhe ye bataiye, how did you react when Anvesh first came out to you?
सबसे पहले तो मैं सबको गुड इवनिंग बोलना चाहती हूँ जो भी वॉच कर रहे हैं अभी. सबसे पहले मैं ये बोलना चाहती हूँ कि ये तो सबसे पहले मुझे नहीं बोला है अनवेश ने, ये अपने सिस्टर को पहले बोला था. मैं बहुत लेट मुझे पता चला, क्योंकि मैं स्कूल करियर में जब था तब भी नहीं पता था. जब ये बीटेक करने गया तो वो सेकेंड ईयर था ना, तो
सेकेंड ईयर था. सेकेंड ईयर से पहले हम छुट्टी मनाने आए थे.
हाँ, सेकेंड ईयर में ये घर और अपने बहन, मतलब मेरी बेटी भी थी अभी था. ये अचानक से ऐसे ही, मेरे को अभी भी याद है, वो डाइनिंग टेबल पे ऊपर पापा उसके बैठे हुए हैं, मैं किचन में काम कर रही थी, खाना बना रही थी. अचानक से ऐसे, मतलब इसको सिस्टर को पहले दिन रात को बोला कि मैं बोलूंगा, तो इसकी सिस्टर ने बोला नहीं मम्मी पापा तेरी पढ़ाई की वजह से बहुत टेंशन में रहते थे, अब मत बोलो, टेंशन में आ जाएंगे. तो इसने सोच लिया होगा कि नहीं अब तो बताना है, तो अचानक से ऐसे बोल दिया कि मैं गे हूँ. तो मैं तो सच में बोलूँ, मैं तुरंत इसके सामने ना कुछ नहीं रिएक्ट किया, मैं एकदम आज नॉर्मल मैं किचन में चली गई. लेकिन जो वर्ड है मेरे कान में वो गूंज रही थी, क्या इसने बोला, क्या इसने बोला. मैं सच में इसको एकदम रिएक्ट नहीं किया था, एकदम से नहीं रिएक्ट किया था.
मुझे लग नहीं रहा, मुझे सब पता चल गया
अचानक. मतलब क्या बोला है, कुछ नहीं.
इसको अभी फील अनवेश एट दैट पॉइंट,
अभी नहीं पता है.
व्हेन शी डिड रिएक्ट,
शी एक्चुअली बिकेम स्टोइक एट वंस, बट आई कुड सी दैट देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ एंजाइटी दैट वाज बिल्डिंग अप, been building inside her. So I know that she went inside the kitchen, and it was an article through which that I had actually come out. I had written an article for Pink Pages. So I said, you know, let me just take that article to my father. He read it, and then he read that word gay, and then my mother heard that and she was like all over the place. But I knew that a lot was going on within her, and my father was rather calm. But mom, I knew that there was a lot going on inside her. There was a lot going on inside both of them. But I think papa is a little better at, you know,
normal covering his... Normal. मैं इनको देख रही थी, इनका फेस कैसा चल रहा है, एकदम नॉर्मल थे. और मैं किचन में चली गई, मैं भी नॉर्मल थी, मैं कुछ नहीं बोल रही थी. मैं कुछ फिर मिक्सी में पीस लिया, खाना बनाया, फिर मैं सोच रही थी क्या बोला. मतलब सच में मेरे कान में गूंज रहा था ये क्या बोल रहा है. तो फिर उसके बाद मैं कुछ नहीं बोली, मैं एकदम कुछ नहीं बोला. लेकिन जैसे जैसे मेरा दिन बीतता गया, ये जो वर्ड बोला है वो मैं सोचती गई, ज्यादा सोचती गई. आज ए मदर जो भी है, मदर तो हूं ही, तो बच्चा अब उसके बारे में मैंने, मुझे कुछ भी नहीं पता था. तो मुझे तो सबसे बड़ी चीज लग रहा था, मैं रात को सोने जाती थी ना, आंख बंद करते ही मुझे मेरे सामने जैसे पिक्चर चल रहा है, इसने क्या बोला, इसने क्या बोला, सच ये बोल रहा है कि झूठ बोल रहा है, ये है कि नहीं, पता नहीं क्या बोल रहा है ये. मतलब बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस आते थे. फिर मैं इसको मैं बोलती थी क्या तुम बोल रहे हो मम्मी, मैं जो हूँ तो हूँ. तो फिर मैं धीरे 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 मुझे, लेकिन सच में मैं बोलूँ, इसको भी पता है, जिसकी दीदी को भी पता है, एक महीना शायद मैं रोई हूँ इस चीज को लेके. एक महीना मैं रोई, खुद को एडजस्ट कर रही थी कि जो ये बोल रहा है वो सच है शायद। तो इसको मैंने फिर धीरे 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 डिस्कस करती रही कि क्या तुम ऐसे क्यों बोलते हो, क्या मुझे तो कुछ नहीं लग रहा है ऐसे। तो फिर अपना ये बोलता गया, नहीं मम्मी ऐसा ऐसा, मतलब जो भी इसके साथ जो भी चलता रहा लाइफ में, जो भी था उसने बताया। फिर कुछ कुछ ऐसे बात बताया जो मैं सुन के बहुत, मैं शॉक्ड भी हो जा रही थी कि ये मेरा बेटा है।
To be very honest, first of all, I had no expectations when I came out to either of my parents. And I didn't want to have any expectations. I was 17, 18. So I just went out and just, I had to share it with them. And then right away, my thought process was, you know what? It took me so long. And I'm so glad that my 18-year-old self was mature enough to process this information that, you know, it took me at least, you know, good 2 to 3 years to really come to terms with me being gay. So really, I need to give my parents the same amount of time to really understand what this really means, what its repercussions might be, because there are going to be. I mean, let's face it, I came out 7-8 years ago and the world was a very different place. India was a very different place than what it is to, even today. And even today, we are not, to be very honest, not that inclusive. But back then, it was even worse. And I was just worried about, you know, what are the kind of answers that they are going to come up with, because there are going to be questions against them. And even today, when you go on a lot, when you go on and watch a video of mine on YouTube, there are still comments about, you know, very homophobic, very hateful comments, not just about me, sometimes even about my parents. So it is definitely tough for as much, you know, difficult for them as it is sometimes for me. So
I'm just एक member देख रही है आप हमारा live और उनका नाम है कमल लिनी। तो वो बोल रहे हैं आपको कनक इतना आपको क्यों बुरा लगा कि आपका बेटा gay है, आपके कुछ सपने थे क्या?
देखिए आज मैं जैसे आज ह्यूमन बीइंग जैसे बोलते हर मदर की होती है, एक बेटा है एक बेटी है, तो हर मदर की ऐसे होता है सपना, ये आम चीज है, ये खाली मैं हूं करके ऐसा नहीं है। हर मदर को ये रहता है कि मेरा बेटी एक है मेरा बेटा एक है, तो हर मदर को रहता ही है, ये तो ऑब्वियस बात, ये तो बहुत ही आम जनता को रहता है ये सेम चीज। मेरे को जो रहता है वो सब मदर को रहता है। अब देखो जानने के बाद हम एक्वेंटेड होते हैं या इस चीज को एक्सेप्ट करते हैं, फिर हम डिफरेंट लेवल में चले जाते हैं। लेकिन शुरुआत में जब पता नहीं होता है ना, तो हर मदर का सपना यही होता है। मैं खाली नहीं हूँ, मैं हर मदर के लिए बोलती हूँ, हर मदर का ऐसे ही होता है।
आई अंडरस्टैंड। आपने बुक में बोला है कनक जी, यू सेड दैट your daughter refused a marriage because they would not accept Anvesh. I can make out that Anvesh, she is very close to you, your sister. So aapne aise kaise kiya, ye story thoda bataiye ki aapne kyun wo rishta refuse kar liya, aur aada aapke daughter ne refuse kiya?
Actually kya hai wo जो रिश्ता चल रहा था उनके घर में ये बात थी कि उनके जो लड़का था, वो जो लड़का बात करता था मेरी बेटी से, वो लड़का मुझे लगता है एक्सेप्ट कर लिया था। लेकिन उसने मेरे बेटी को बोला कि मेरे मदर को जब ये मतलब मैंने बताई, मेरे बेटी ने देखो उसको बता दिया कि देखो मेरे भाई ऐसा है। तो मेरे बेटी क्या सोची, मैं सच बोल दूं कि बाद में मेरे लिए ये ना प्रॉब्लम करे। लेकिन वो लड़का क्या किया, वो भी आराम से सुन लिया और वो भी इतना सीरियस नहीं लिया, वो भी अपनी मदर को बोल दिया उसके भाई का मतलब ऐसे ऐसे करके। उसके मदर उसकी बेटा को बोला कि उसके अपना बड़े बेटे को बोल दिया, बड़े बेटे को बोल दिया कि ऐसे ऐसे हुआ है, इसका भाई ऐसा है। तो उसकी बड़ा भाई ने उसकी मदर को शायद बोला होगा, नहीं मामा तो राजी नहीं होंगे, इसका भाई ऐसा है ये है वो है करके। तो उस लड़के जब मदर मतलब मदर और उनके बेटे के कुछ बातचीत हुई, तो वो मेरे बेटी को आके बोला कि ऐसा ऐसा हुआ था कि मेरे माँ जानने ये बोल रही हैं कि तुम उसका भाई ऐसा है तो हम कैसे शादी कर सकते हैं, मतलब मैं बड़ा भाई तुम्हारा तैयार नहीं हो रहा है। तो मेरी बेटी ने बोला कि मेरे भाई पागल है, मेरा भाई क्या है, मेरा भाई कितना ऊपर है, आपको कुछ भी नहीं पता मेरे भाई के बारे में, मेरा भाई यहाँ सेटल भी नहीं होगा, मेरा भाई के साथ आपने मिले नहीं है, मेरा भाई पता नहीं उसका तो सपना कहाँ है, मैं भी उसके उस तक नहीं पहुंच पा रही हूँ, आप मेरे भाई के लिए क्या बोल रहे, आप मेरे भाई को जानते नहीं है, बात ही नहीं किया, मेरे भाई से मिला ही नहीं आपने। लेकिन उसने बोला नहीं मैं तो जानती हूँ, लेकिन ये चीज जब मेरे माँ को बताया तो मेरे माँ ऐसे बोला। तो जब मेरी बेटी ये सुनी, मेरी बेटी दुखी हो गई कि ये क्या बात हुई इस चीज की। मेरे को बताई कि माँ ऐसे ऐसे, मम्मी ऐसे ऐसे बोला। तो वो लड़का, मैंने कहा अच्छा ये चीज उनकी माँ ने ऐसे बात बता दी। बोली हाँ ये बात बता रहे, तो बेटी को तो ऑब्वियसली खराब
आई
लगेगा ही।
थिंक दिस थॉट प्रोसेस इज सच अ स्टोन एज थॉट प्रोसेस ऑफ यू नो नॉट एक्सेप्टिंग इट. टू मी इट्स वेरी, आई मीन राइट नाउ आई हैव बीन आउट फॉर सो लॉन्ग दैट यू नो एट दिस इंटायर नैरेटिव ऑफ हेटिंग गे पीपल और यू नो थिंकिंग दैट देयर इज समथिंग रॉन्ग विदाउट इवन नोइंग और अंडरस्टैंडिंग ट्राइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड अस इज जस्ट सो अनइमेजिनेबल टू मी. सो आई डोंट वेस्ट अ लॉट ऑफ माई टाइम एंड आई थिंक दैट्स इट्स द सेम विद अंकिता एज वेल. लाइक एवरी टाइम शी कम्स अक्रॉस समथिंग दैट इज होमोफोबिक फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल शी टेक्स अ स्टैंड नाउ हरसेल्फ बिकॉज आई मीन शी अंडरस्टैंड्स शी इज बीन एन अलाय ऑल अलॉन्ग एंड शी
वंडरफुल
अंडरस्टैंड्स व्हाट इट मीन्स टू व्हाट इट एक्चुअली मेंट फॉर मी टू बी गे एंड आई एम ऑल्सो अ सर्टन काइंड ऑफ गे. लेट्स बी ऑनेस्ट अबाउट इट हियर. आई एम माय जेंडर एक्सप्रेशन इज वेरी एंड्रोजिनस. आई एम इफेमिनेट. दैट्स माय डिमीनर समथिंग दैट आई डिडंट चूज एंड शी हैज सीन मी बीइंग मॉक्ड यू नो थ्रू एंड थ्रू माय स्कूल लाइफ समटाइम्स इवन थ्रू कॉलेज sometimes even at work. So she knows the kind of, you know, trials and tribulations that I've been through and I've always tried to overcome them. So this very narrative of hating someone for being gay or for being queer to me is just so unimaginable and so unnecessary that we don't even want to acknowledge that kind of, you know, emotion at all.
Got it. So I have a lot of people watching and Amita says, I agree with you. कमलिनी बोल रही है आई अंडरस्टैंड, मेरा भी एक बेटी और बेटा था पर मेरे मेरा बेटा ट्रांसजेंडर निकला। धक्का मुझे ज्यादा इसीलिए लगा कि उसे कितना कष्ट हुआ है इतने सालों से, सबसे पहले बेटे पर क्या बीती होगी। तो आई थिंक एज अ मॉम इट्स ऑलवेज यू थिंक ऑफ योर चाइल्ड फर्स्ट। तो उन्होंने ये अग्री किया। तो कनक जी, आपने बुक में बोला है कि यू वांट टू अबॉलिश द टर्म एलजीबीटी प्लस, यू डोंट वांट देम कि वो अलग एक यू नो ग्रुप बने। तो इसका आप क्या सोचते हैं प्लीज थोड़ा।
मैंने इसलिए बोला था कि ऐसे ग्रुप करके जैसे आप बोलोगे ना, तो सोसाइटी क्या है उसको ना अलग चीज में लेता है। जैसे ना ये अच्छा ये ट्रांसजेंडर ये अच्छा ये मतलब ये क्यों अलग से करना है तो आम जनता ब्रेन तो सार्व है ही इन लोग की, फिर किस बात की कमी है, किस बात की कमी है जो इन लोग का अलग वार्ड देना है। मैं इसलिए उनको स्पेशली उन लड़कियों को बोला था, मैंने कहा क्यों अलग लोड, मैं तो वही चाहती हूँ ये वार्ड ही उठ जाए, सब इक्वल रहो, इक्वल ही है ये लोग तो, इक्वल ही है, क्यों अलग करना है।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल। हमारी एक मेंबर बोल रही है बीइंग गे इज नॉट अ डिजीज। I really wonder why people behave like this.
बस यही आड़ में बोलते कि डिजीज तो है ही नहीं।
हाँ
यार हमारा भी गलती नहीं है, ठीक है ये हमारा भी गलती नहीं है, या हमारा बच्चे में कोई मतलब खूबियां है, मतलब जैसे बोलते हैं कुछ प्रॉब्लम है, प्रॉब्लम भी नहीं है, फिर क्या किसलिए अलग करना, किस बात के लिए अलग करना।
In fact, I used to tell mommy that you know what, you know, God loves you so much that He has gifted you with a masterpiece, which is why it's so different from all the rest of the kids around us. So you should be more grateful.
इसलिए हमेशा शुरुआत में मुझे यही बात बोली है, मम्मी तुम एक मास्टरपीस पैदा की।
सही है ना, बिल्कुल भी। अच्छा अब हम एक आप भी हरियाणा में रहते हो, हम भी हरियाणा में रहते हैं, तो आपने ये सोसाइटी और जैसे कोई पूछता है कि आपका बेटा शादी कब करेगा तो वो कैसे हैंडल किया आपने?
एक तो है कि मेरा बेटा अभी शादी होने लाइक उम्र हुआ नहीं है, छोटा है अभी। बहुत छोटा है ये।
वेरी गुड।
अब क्या है वो तो जब आएगा तब देखा जाएगा, शादी का टाइम जब आएगा। लेकिन अब हरियाणा में हम लोग जरूर रहते हैं पर मैं हरियाणा से बिलोंग नहीं करती हूँ, मैं उड़ीसा से बिलोंग करती हूँ। लेकिन मैं इतना इस चीज का मैं सच में बताऊं कि मैं इतनी लकी हूँ, मैं जिस सोसाइटी में रहती हूँ मैं बहुत अच्छी सोसाइटी में रहती हूँ। जहाँ जैसे हरियाणा में हमारा एनटीपीसी कॉलोनी है, एनटीपीसी आपको पता होगा महारत्न कंपनी करके इसका नाम है, तो बहुत बड़ी कंपनी है। यहाँ पे हम लोग मिक्सअप लोग रहते हैं, हमारा कोई फीलिंग नहीं रहती है, हर स्टेट की हर जात का लोग रहते हैं। तो यहाँ हरियाणा करके कुछ भी नहीं है, कुछ भी नहीं, यहाँ अंदर ना आपको कुछ भी फीलिंग नहीं रहेगा। सारे एजुकेटेड लोग हैं, बल्कि जो भी हरियाणा के लोग यहाँ अंदर भी रहते हैं, हमारे इंजीनियर्स भी है, सब लोग बहुत एजुकेटेड, बहुत स्मार्ट लड़ी है, बहुत अच्छे डांस करते हैं, सब लोग बहुत इसको सपोर्ट भी करते हैं, क्योंकि इसके बारे में सबको, हर कोई किसी को पता है, क्योंकि कोई फोन कर देगा भाभी आज बेटा का, अनवेश का आज ना नडा में पेपर में आया है। मैंने कहा हाँ उसका तो आता रहता है, मतलब उनको लगा कि मैं पहली बार सुन रही हूँ, तो अच्छा आता रहता है। मैंने कहा हाँ अच्छा हाउ लकी वा, तो मैंने कहा इसको तो आता रहता है।
Yeah, I was just saying that we live in such a pan-Indian atmosphere. I mean, I've grown up always, even when we were in Odisha, we were still in a, you know, NTPC township, and NTPC townships have always been very pan-Indian. So I have never, or for that matter, even my friends we've never looked at someone through the lens of, you know, their religion or their caste or their gender. We just look at each individual as, you know, empowered, strong individuals. And therefore, that narrative of, you know, othering someone, which my mom was just talking about, you know, trying to, you know, tag someone and othering them, it has honestly never really existed. And even if there are, you know, people who might sometimes, you know, come up with, you know, negative opinions, I think you just, you know, you learn over the years to, you know, look at the glass as half full. And we're always grateful for everything that we do have, instead of, you know, fretting over anything that we don't have at all.
That's just fabulous, Anvesh. So I did not officially introduce Anvesh to y'all. He's a visual designer, the first Indian recipient of the Troy Perry Medal of Pride for compassionate activism. He's also the youngest winner of Mr. Gay World India and creator of The Ephemeraire. He blogs over there, and it's a parallel universe where he gets to illustrate the utopian world he wants to be a part of. So Anvesh, tell me, how do you recommend handling allyship at home?
Yeah, I think I'm really glad that you asked that question, because let's be honest, especially when your kid happens to be, you know, queer or, you know, LGBTIQA+, I think that is probably one of the most, you know, difficult things to sort of deal with, because, you know, when you have a friend who's gay, you meet that friend, but they all go back home at the end of the day. And especially, like, you know, the way we are right now in a post-corona world, like, we're all at home all the time right now. And I've read, in fact, a lot of articles about how, you know, sometimes it becomes very difficult for queer kids to, you know, to have to live with parents who don't really understand them. And I completely get them. I completely understand how difficult it can be for, you know, someone who's always had, you know, the kind of dreams that they usually do and grow up with for their own kids, the kind of dreams that my mother had as well, you know, the kind of expectations that you usually have in Indian society. I think you do grow up with that kind of, it's just in your DNA. Sometimes you can't even help it. And it can be a very difficult journey to sort of, you know, go through. But As queer people, I would recommend that anybody who's coming out to their parents, or anybody who's trying to, you know, build relationships and allies around them, just make sure, understand that this is going to be a very long and sometimes a little tedious process, but it's going to, there's light at the end of this tunnel. So you have to be very patient, you have to be very perseverant, and you have to be very calm through this entire journey. You cannot expect everybody to accept you tomorrow. It didn't happen with me at all. I mean, my closest set of friends, I came out to them at 17. In fact, even before I had actually come out to my sister, I had come out to my school teacher, and because she realized that, you know, I used to just keep, there were times when I would be sitting in the classroom and I would start crying. And she realized that there was something that was not really, you know, right about me, because I was not a very, I was not a quiet person. I was a very talkative, you know, chatty kid in school. And all of a sudden, when I started realizing that I was gay, I had become a very different person, and I was almost slipping into, you know, depression. And I would, you know, switch off my lights and I would scribble on my table, because I just didn't want to talk to anybody. I didn't want to have a conversation with anybody. And I would just be sitting, and all of a sudden I would start crying, because I realized that, you know, my life is probably going to be a very difficult one. And I didn't have anybody to look up to. Let's be honest, I didn't have, you know, queer folks around me who I could look at and be like, okay, wow, this is the kind of person that I would, you know, want to be. Of course, I'm so grateful that I had, you know, to look up to someone like a Harish Iyer or a Parmesh Shahani, Nishit Saran. We've had folks, I mean, a lot of incredible queer activists around us. But it always helps when your next door neighbor, you know, maybe happens to be gay, and you're like, okay, we have something to talk to, or maybe your own, you know, friend in your classroom. None of that happened to me. coming out was a very foreign, you know, thing, and in back then, so it was very difficult for me to process that information. And therefore, when I finally came to terms with it, coming back to your question, just be like, you know, really, really patient dealing with anybody, and you will grow allies, you will grow a lot of friends who will accept you. And it does get better. I want to like reiterate the fact that, you know, don't give up on yourself, don't give up on your life. I've been through that journey, so I know it very well, how hard it can be waking up and knowing that you know your life is worthless because you're just going to be mocked at all your life. I was told that, you know, I will never have a job because I'm gay. And in fact, one of the first jobs that I actually ended up with was because I won Mr. Gay India. So I think I monetized. I successfully monetized my queerness. So
I think so.
So I'm having the last laugh now.
That's excellent. Really, hats off to you. And Kamalini also says, way to go, Anvesh. So tell me a little bit about how your family handled your coming out, Anvesh, like your extended family.
I think they didn't handle it.
The first time you went to a family get together, or, you know.
Yeah, I think they didn't handle it. I handled it because I knew that it was going to be a very difficult discussion or a conversation to have with any of them. So I thought, you know, what if I become Mr. Gay India, then I'll be in the newspapers, then I wouldn't have to come out to anyone. And to be very honest, like I was 19 when I participated in Mr. Gay India. So obviously, like, I was a kid. So this was my thought process that, you know, I was so fed up of coming out again and again, because you don't come out once, you come out again and again and again. And it was becoming so frustrating that I was like, if I become Mr. Gilda, it's going to solve a lot of problems. So, and thankfully, you know, maybe I was delusional enough to believe that I was going to be Mr. Gilda and I won it. And then the next day it was in all the Odia newspapers. It was on all the, you know, I was in Delhi back then. So all the Odia news channels, they send their media, you know, all their journalists to my college. And therefore, everybody actually by default got to know that, you know, I'm gay. But there's a lot more to being gay than just, you know, knowing someone. Is gay. I mean, there's, of course, like you've already, you know, we've already spoken about, you know, shaadi ke questions aate hain, or a lot of other like really weird questions as well, because people are just curious and they don't know how to, you know, frame their questions the right way. In fact, I remember during one of my interviews in Odia, in Odisha, it was with a very, you know, prime time Odia news channel, and he asked me, you know, how is it that you're gay and you've never been you know, abused or sexually molested in your entire life? And I was like, how dare you ask that question to me? That's such an insensitive question to ask. I was like, I don't even know what, you know, how do you even have that kind of a thought process? But I realized that, you know, I am going to be asked a lot of these questions, and I cannot lose my patience, or I can't lose my you know, train of thoughts. I have to be patient, I have to be calm and deal with all of, you know, these questions that, you know, are thrown at me. And I always you know, say that, you know, I was called a lot of different names growing up, but I used all of those names and I built a staircase out of it, and I climbed up that staircase to success instead of, you know, fretting over how awful they were trying to make me feel. So you know, I always think that, you know, if there's something negative that's coming your way, or something that a problem that you have to overcome, it has come your way because, you know, the force above us here, he or she believes that you can really deal with it in the right way. And therefore, if you are getting the, look at it as an opportunity and, you know, face your alligators head on.
Great. I have a lot of praise coming for you, Anvesh, online. How and sweet. I have Swati from Pride Circle who's saying hi to you.
Hi, Swati.
And a lot of God blesses coming to you as well. So to both of you, Kanak and Anvesh. So,
by the way, everybody, my mom's having a star moment right now. This is the first time that she's on a live, you know, screening. So this is you know, you guys should be very grateful that you're getting to see her for the first time.
We are at Gurgaon Moms. We're glad she did it with Gurgaon Moms. Thank you so much. So tell me, Anvesh, where or whom should a confused child or parent reach out to about coming out, about their sexuality? What would you suggest, since you've been there?
I think that's a very tricky question, and it's very contextual. Because I understand that, you know, all kids are very different. Maybe, you know, if you'd asked this question to me 5 years ago, I would have had a very pageanty answer to it. But I think now that I have dealt with more cases, and I see there are a lot of people who reach out to me constantly on social media and otherwise, I think I understand now that every child has a different kind of journey, because every child is also different. Their parents are different. So everybody's going to have a very unique experience. However, I have also noticed that, you know, I also belong to the queer millennial generation. So I found a lot of my answers on the internet. And now I think with access to the internet, a lot of other folks in, like, you know, two tier, three tier cities in India, in smaller towns and smaller villages in India also have access to the internet, where they sometimes do, you know, find a lot of, you know, answers to their questions. Which is why I believe that it is extremely important for us as a society to make sure that we are putting out, you know, good, healthy content from which showcases, you know, queer people in more empowered light in the popular media. And popular media does play a huge role in a country like ours, where we consume Bollywood, we consume, you know, especially with OTT now coming into the picture, that's what people do through, I mean, that's what people have been doing all through this entire, you know, quarantine. So, and that does play a very important role on all of our minds. And therefore, it is very important that, you know, folks like me or folks like whoever is like an artist or you know, there are so many different, you know, people from the queer community who are doing really incredible job on the social media, or even like, you know, filmmakers. I think, I do think that it becomes our responsibility then, because now we can afford to put out a certain kind of content and back it up, because there is a certain kind of following now that we have. So, you know, it's important that we take that bait in our hands and then say that, okay, this is how we want us to be represented. And this is how you should, you know, try and learn more about us. You know, we're having this conversation right now. This is how you change these conversations that are negative to a more positive narrative about queer people in general. People will get to see me now. People will get to see my mother. And they will understand that, okay, these are just people just like you and me. They could be our next door neighbors, and that's absolutely fine. I do believe that, I think when you're in that situation, you don't want to actually go and reach out to anybody. You want to reach out to Google, and you want to answer, you want Google to answer all your questions like the way I wanted all my questions to be answered by them. And I'm very glad that, you know, I had access to maybe a show like Taboo, where I would see all, you know, people from different, you know, the entire gender spectrum. It was a documentary that used to be on Nat Geo, I believe. And it really, that documentary really changed my life, because it told me that, okay, there are different kinds of people from the entire gender spectrum. And it's a spectrum. It's not a binary concept anymore. What is the difference between gender and sex? Something that I didn't know at all growing up, at all. And over the years, of course, you know, you come across a lot of, I had, of course, access to the internet. So I went out and, you know, looked out for all different kinds of documentary, of Freddie Mercury, of, you know, of Yves Saint Laurent. I would watch the documentaries and films about them and learn so much about them and their journeys. And I would pick different, you know, things that I liked about them or their stories. And I'd be like, okay, this is how I want to be. This is how I can, you know, maybe change the narrative about me. And I do remember, in fact, a lot of our viewers might have also seen the song "I Want to Break Free" from Queen by Freddie Mercury, where he goes in drag. And I was like, oh, arre wah, aisa bhi ho sakta hai ki moochhe hain aur dress bhi pehna hai, aisa bhi kuch ho sakta hai. So drag was also a new concept for me. I didn't know anything about it. But that's how you dheere dheere karke, you start realizing, okay, these are the kind of possibilities that there can be. And that the knowledge makes you more patient. Let's be honest. It makes you more calm. And once you educate yourself, then you can also have a more healthier conversation with, you know, your parents or anybody who's around you.
That's great. That's great, Anvesh. Tell me a little bit about the effeminate.
Yes, effeminate. Yeah. So that's actually the name of my blog. I started it out way back in 2014. I mean, these days nobody watches the Preet's blog anymore. So now it's like, it has transformed and it has translated into, you know, a space where I just make art that I can totally associate with on Instagram. And effeminate was actually a way for me to, you know, reclaim the word effeminate, because every time we associate effeminacy with someone, we constantly look down upon them. And effeminate is also a Latin word, which actually means, literally means that, you know, being associated to femininity, and it means as something lesser. And I was like, you know, being feminine or being effeminate is nothing is no less than being, you know, masculine. And I can, you know, reclaim it and, you know, make it a more beautiful space. And I'm so glad that in the last 7-8 years, I've put out so much art and so much love I have received as well from people who follow my work. It's just my way of, you know, spreading happiness and telling my story as well. And I think back then I didn't have anybody around me who was, you know, telling all these, you know, stories about, you know, teenaged queer people. I was like, I need to take, you know, responsibility. And if I can afford to write about my story, let me share it with other people and see how they react to my content. And over the years, of course, now I make a lot of beautiful art. I make, you know, I represent, you know, non-binary people. I represent, you know, femme men. And I use this hashtag femme is beautiful, because femme really is beautiful and it should not be looked down upon in any way at all.
Lovely. That's lovely. So I have both Amita and Kamalini saying what a grounded young man you are. Oh. And they are very happy that Gurgaon Moms has brought up this topic. Yes. And and Anshu also says thank you for sharing your journey with us. Tell me, Anvesh, the big day, the landmark judgment, when that took place, where were you and how did it feel? How did you celebrate?
So I was in Delhi back then and I was doing a master's from NIFT. So okay. I was in the campus back then and I had my first class had just gotten over. So I got to know about it. Of course, we were all keeping up with it on Twitter. And of course, we're all connected. I mean, the queer community is quite, I wouldn't say small, because I think then it just sort of invisibilizes us in some ways. But it's actually very well connected. So we were all just keeping up with the timeline. And then when I finally got to know about it, I think right away, even before I could process it, I right away got calls from all these journalists who had taken my contact from way back in 2016. And they were like, you know, we want your bite. We want to know what your feeling is and how are you, you know, celebrating today. And to be very honest, I think more than celebration, there was just more than ecstasy. It was just peace at that point in time. We were like, you know, finally, I mean, thank God, this is like one step at least, you know, in the right direction. And we really have a very, very, very long way to go. But at least finally, we've taken that one step forward and it's a good start. So I was just, to be very honest, just calm and just, I was just like, we should have been here, you know, 5 years ago. Thank God that we are finally here.
We have come a long way. Thank God for that.
Exactly. So I think, I mean, everybody was anyway celebrating. And I think after the judgment came in place, I mean, Sharif is a very good friend of mine who got us all over from a lot of our friends. So we went and we celebrated at his place. I remember we had Anjali Gopalan from the NAS Foundation who was there. You know, she was, I mean, of course, a pioneering figure, an incredible ally to the community who has, you know, paved the path for a lot of queer people, at least in, you know, Delhi NCR. She's created a safe space for a lot of us. So we were just very happy to just be together again. And, you know, finally, Sharif was like, finally, I thought I would never get to see it in my entire lifetime happening in India, but it's happening. So I was just happy and just at peace that, you know, finally we were moving forward.
That's lovely. That's really, really wonderful to hear. So coming back to the book, Anvesh, which is your, besides your mom's, of course, which is your favorite story and why?
It's actually Arora Ji.
आप बताएं कि आपको कौन सा story सबसे अच्छा लगा?
It's favorite to both of us, actually, Aruna Ji's. I think we both connect to her story for the same reasons. Right. I think, first of all, I mean, Aruna Ji has been quite an inspiration to me for a very, very long time. And she says through her story about, you know, coming to terms with, you know, the coming out of her own son and learning to be and such an incredible ally. She spoke about not being accusatory and being not being judgmental about it. And I think that's something that I connected with a lot, because that's exactly what happens when perhaps that's what also happened somehow between, you know, my mother and me. So there was an element of, you know, OK, I connect with this. This is exactly what had happened with me, because somehow it does happen, you know. Even when I had come out to my mother, she started accusing herself, and she was like, she started accusing God, and she was like, you know, why did it happen to me? How can it happen to me? Why me? and you realize that okay, it's time for us to
what
really
did
like,
I do wrong? मैंने क्या गलत किया?
Exactly. So and I completely understand and completely related to that aspect of a story that you know you can't be accusatory at all. You have to just be calm and you have to be patient and you have to be non-judgmental when you really like you come coming across these stories. And I think this entire idea of being non-judgmental is I still think is fairly new in India, and I'm glad that it's finally making us you know penetrating deeper in India finally. But it's good that you know people now think twice before saying anything to anybody for that matter, not just queer people. I mean, let's be honest. I mean, we're all brought up in a certain way, and it's in our DNA. Sometimes even I have been you know homophobic when I didn't know anything about the queer community, which is why I was having such a difficult time you know coming to terms with my sexuality. Had I been you know completely okay with my sexuality, then I would have not had an issue with being gay. But initially when I started out, of course I had an issue with it because that's how we are brought up in the society. That's what
conditioned.
Exactly. That's what we see in popular media. Again, I mean, I remember watching Dostana and feeling, oh God. I mean, is this how you know being gay is? Then I don't want to be gay. So, I mean, thankfully over the years we've been able to change that narrative with time, with patience. But yeah, it's been a journey. But I'm glad that we've been on this journey.
I think Bollywood has also evolved, right, in their representation and. Especially with the OTT platforms coming out, it's so much more out there.
It's also because a lot of queer folks are finally also making a mark in, you know, Bollywood. You have an Apoorva Asrani writing more empowering stories, an Aligarh with a superstar like Manoj Bajpayee. You know, someone you would have never thought that you know a superstar in 1970s would be playing a gay man, but you know he was. And I met Manojji the other day, and he was just like. It was just a character to me. He didn't even look at it as, you know, acha gay man hai to main karunga hi nahi character. He was like, I mean, it's just a character. It's just a person. And I was so happy to see that, you know, a superstar like him can finally, you know, say that, you know, it's just a character to me. And he's a human being. And I'm going to play the character that has been provided, that I'm being provided with. And that's how, you know, the change in narrative really begins. So I'm glad, you know, people like Apoorva or people like Ghazal, they're writing, they're bringing in their stories. They're bringing in their, you know, stories that are in their context, which is why I'm talking about contextual queerness. You know, you need to talk about your stories because nobody else is going to talk about it. Aapko hi apni story share karni padegi, and that's how things will move forward.
Lovely. I have Dr. Anjali Parashar online, and she says, thank you, Gurgaon moms, for touching this topic and giving us this opportunity to meet Anvesh and Kanak. Awesome. You're most welcome, Dr. Anjali. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the comments box now. And thank you so much for watching. That really helps. The book is lovely. I love the stories. Nandita Das's story is also lovely.
Yes.
And I did read quite a few that were really, really nice. Tell me, Anvesh, do hate crimes still exist these days?
Of course they do. Yeah. I mean, where are we? We're not living in Norway or Switzerland in some Scandinavian nation where everything is a rainbow. We have. Let's face it. I mean, I don't even think our government is very pro LGBTIQA+. When the Section 377 judgment came in place, we didn't have a single you know tweet or acknowledgement from the ruling government right now, and that really matters because the current government has an incredible influence on the minds of this country, and it's incredibly important that you know they share their support for the community and when a judgment like this happens, and therefore I mean hate crimes are very much you know prevalent in the country, and more so I mean mummy knows about it. There have been I was living in Delhi for a really long time. I did my bachelor's and then my master's there, so I would be so scared sometimes, you know, even wearing you know my heels and just walking out in the open, because I'd be like, you know, I used to carry my heels in a bag. And then I used to go auto mein jaane ke baad aur college mein nikal ke, I used to change my sneakers into my heels, and then I would walk into the college, and then before coming back I'd change my heels, wear my shoes, and then keep my heels inside my bag and then walk off. So I mean it is a difficult place sometimes to you know also project your queerness, which is why I'm saying that you know it's very different from you know just accepting gay. you know, it's easier to accept someone who's gay who can just pass off as a heterosexual, or that, or just passes off through that, you know, heteronormative, you know, identity. But it's very difficult for, you know, queer folks who are also visibly very different from a lot of our cisgender heterosexual counterparts. And for us, it's very empowering. I think people don't realize that, you know, me wearing heels is something that makes me feel a certain way. And I mean, why should I not be able to, you know, express my identity and express myself openly and freely out in the open? And there are going to be questions, and there shouldn't be. I mean, theek hai, aap sawal bhi pooch rahe ho, like, I mean, at least try and listen to us, try and understand what we're trying to say, try and decipher what's really coming out of our mouths. It's extremely important to, of course, again, not be non-judgmental when it comes to, you know, dealing with queer people. And it's going to take a, I mean, there's a lot of, by the way, queer phobia, homophobia on the internet right now.
I was going to ask you, Anvesh, on the topic of heels, what happens when you go to buy them? Like, so pre-corona times in shops.
So I actually buy them online. I'm smarter. I belong to the queer millennial generation who buys everything on the smartphone.
Online. So I imagine a salesman saying, "Aapke liye," you know.
It's very difficult. I mean, I remember even when it comes to, you know, buying a lip color, like I, and by the way, like, makeup is something that everybody wears. All the greatest of actors that we've seen, they've all worn it on when they're in front of the camera. So I would go and, you know, buy. I mean, I love makeup, and I do this no makeup. Look, no makeup look a lot of the times. I mean, of course, I mean, I'm the product of a beauty pageant. I've been modeling for so many years. I need my makeup, and I need to refill it sometimes. And I prefer, you know, going to an offline store instead of buying makeup online, because it's easier that way. So I would go, and there were times, you know, especially I remember in Bangalore once after work, I went out with my friends to buy this one lip color, and I was like trying it, and all the ladies there, they were all just completely gobsmacked, or sab mod mod ke dekh rahe hain ki kya ho raha hai, what is happening, how, and I'm like, I'm putting the lipstick so much better than any of the other girls out there, and they're just completely shocked. And I'm like, okay, this is how, you know, maybe change will happen, you know, when maybe they will one day, you know, get used to men buying makeup. And yeah, I think it's been a process over time, dheere dheere karke. I remember the very first time, by the way, I had to buy a pair of heels. So what I did was I bought something that was like an Oxford shoe, but had a little bit of a heel. And thankfully, I managed to, you know, find a few online. And I was initially planning to actually go and buy it with a friend, because I was like, I'll go and ask, you know, we measured our foot size, and I was like, you know, तुम आ जाना मेरे साथ और तुम्हारे लिए बोल के मैं मेरे लिए ले लूंगा वो शू. But eventually I finally found the shoe online. So I was like, thank God I don't have to go to the store, because it can be very, very awkward. And I do remember this one time a seller, you know, he made a very obscure, a very a remark which was not very, you know, pleasing. And I just felt like, you know, maybe it's safer if I buy, you know, stuff online instead of going to an offline store and actually buying it, because sometimes it can be unsafe as well. And in fact, even when I was living in Okhla, there was a guy who started, you know, I remember he started stalking me, and I realized that, okay, you know, even if, you know, I'm being stalked, I can't even, like, who do I even go and reach out to and say, acha, I'm being stalked by this guy? Because, you know, a guy being stalked by another guy might be a very foreign concept to a lot of other people, but it is the reality for a lot of boys, by the way, in India. So a lot of queer boys. And I was like, you know, I need to be careful, and I need to make sure that when I'm going out, at least when I'm in Delhi, I need to make sure that, you know, I'm more heteronormatively dressed and not like a queer person. So those are problems that we do constantly deal with.
I hope it changes someday, Anvesh, for you especially. And it's
been,
I really, really hope so. And I think you were talking about Arunima, right? So she's also online watching. Arunima Sarkar, I think she's written one of the stories, right?
Yes. Okay. Hi, Arunima.
So it's lovely that she's also watching. And everybody's really, really happy with the session. Everyone's sending y'all a lot of love, a lot of regards. And I would like to thank Srini, Priyanka.
Oh my God, and, have to thank Srini and Ram. Thank you so much for getting
everyone at Pride Circle, Pride Allies, and Geetu of Rupa Publications as well for sending me the book on time. And that's really like, it's a lovely, lovely, interesting book. And we have two very interesting author events online coming up. So viewers, do watch the Gurgaon Moms Facebook page for more. We'll let you know on Monday what we have coming up. And everybody stay home, stay safe, take care. And thank you so much again, Kanak and Anvesh, for joining us.
Thank you so much for having us.
Really appreciate
it. Lovely to see you. And again, you look beautiful today, by the way. And I'm loving this coordination with the book. I think Upasna is completely stealing the light away from me today, which I'm not happy about at all. I should have put more effort now.
You should have worn your makeup and come on, Vish.
I'm going to hold you on that forever Dan, now.
You take a makeup session for us anytime. You just have to tell me when.
But thoda sa maine lagaya hai highlighter, you know. But it's not enough. It's totally being overshadowed by Upasna's lovely outfit and Upasna's aura. But I think today I have to just deal with it.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for watching. Thank you.